Alert! It's the beginning of wildflower season in California. These hills are normally crusty and brown, but every spring they come to life, gushing with colors. This was a particularly wet year. People are talking about a super bloom throughout the state. One of the first areas to peak was here at Diamond Valley Lake. Thousands of people have come to take photos of themselves standing in the flowers.
I'm in the flowers.
There are beautiful swaths of orange, yellow, blue, and purple.
Die, stupid flowers. Take that. Take that. Oh, take that. Yeah, ooh, take that. Haha, take that. Ugh. Die.
Such a beautiful view of Diamond Valley Lake with the wildflowers. Crystal clear water, the beautiful hills.
Oh yeah, working, buddy. Oh, yeah, you're such a model. Let me get the other camera. Oh, yeah.
The wildflower trail is 2.1 miles long and leads through multicolored hills with views of the surrounding snow-capped mountains. Throughout the trail, you can find oranges from the California poppies. This species is the California state flower, and the large iconic blooms can be found interspersed with trash alongside freeways throughout the state. When you see orange hills, you can bet that they're California poppies. They can grow in dense fields that turn the hills solid orange. From this viewpoint, you can also see the snow-capped Mount San Jacinto on the right and Mount San Gorgonio on the left. These are the two highest peaks in Southern California. Of the many yellows out here, the predominant species is the California goldfields, which give these hills their brilliant yellow. They're in the daisy or sunflower family, which is easily recognized by their unique flower structure. Though each of these looks like a single normal flower, every petal and each of the center bits is actually an individual modified flower. Brittlebush is another member of the daisy family and is more common further into the arid desert regions. Also present are fiddlenecks with their curved stalks and, yes, stinknet, a non-native known for its fragrance. This is baby blue eyes, one of the only pure blue wildflowers and an incredible contrast to the oranges and yellows. Many flowers are called blue, but are in fact much closer to violet. These are unmistakably blue and a real treat to see in large patches. Here's a nice streak of blue eyes, then fiddlenecks, then goldfields, then poppies. The hills also had smaller groups of different purples. This is Coulter's lupin, which belongs to the legume family, like beans and peas. Lupins are easily recognizable by their vertical flower stalks and distinct flower and leaf shape. These are called blue dicks, but they look purple and not like a dick. This is desert chia, which has these dense bunches of tiny flowers on tall vertical stalks. Native Americans in this area use this chia as a food and medicine. And these are the best, deepest, largest purple flowers out there. Wild Canterbury bells. This is a species of scorpionweed, which are incredibly diverse in California. It's a member of the borage or forget-me-not family, like the fiddleneck.
Oh, did you see there's like flowers up here? Whoa, check this out.
Now on to pinks. These are red maids, which were less common, but brilliantly magenta colored. And this one is the caterpillar scorpion weed in the same genus as Canterbury bells, known for its fuzzy flower buds reminiscent of caterpillars. There were only small groups of whites, which were made up of clearwater cryptantha and chaparral gilead. And lastly, we have all the invasive humans. People seem to be the largest threat to these wildflower populations. Most wildflowers are annuals, so trampling the flowers kills them before they can produce seed for the next generation. Additionally, soil compaction will negatively affect the ecosystem and further disrupt the native species. This is looking to be a big wildflower year, and I'll be chasing the bloom all through the spring.